Hello, my friend. How you doing today? Let us attempt to satisfy your thirst. As usual, we'll share with you some of the latest and greatest space updates. We'll start with an update to explain how a SpaceX civilian astronaut who flew in orbit for 3 days joins rival company Blue Origin as an engineer. Then an update on SpaceX launching 10 rockets for every one rocket launched by its biggest adversary will come once this topic is covered. So, let's start with our first update. Chris Sembroski, a data engineer from the Seattle region, experienced his first trip into space last year aboard SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule. However, he now works full-time as an avionics engineer at Blue Origin. Sembroski did not mention the rivalry between Jeff Bezos, the billionaire founder of Amazon and Blue Origin, and Elon Musk, the billionaire founder of SpaceX, as seen by newly released photos collected by NASA's James Webb Space Telescope, or JWST, he emphasized the allure of the space frontier. "Space beckons us. It taunts us," he wrote. As per Sembroski, "images of our universe from Hubble and JWST pull on our desires to explore and to seek out new adventures." He also added, "I'm thrilled to be a part of our expansion out to the rest of the universe and to announce I have joined Blue Origin. Let's go." Sembroski's work title is listed as avionics engineer on his LinkedIn page, and a picture of Blue Origin's orbital glass New Glenn rocket in flight is included in the tweet, but he didn't elaborate on his specific duties at the business. When he was selected as one of four crew members for the charitable Inspiration 4 space mission last September, Sembroski, who formerly worked on Minuteman missiles for the U.S. Air Force, was a fault detection and diagnostics lead engineer for Lockheed Martin in Everett, Washington. He benefited from a winning lottery ticket that a buddy purchased but chose not to attempt the orbital journey. Sembroski, Dr. Cyan Proctor, a geoscientist, and Haley Arsenault, a medical assistant and childhood cancer survivor, were each given a seat on the voyage, which was chartered by billionaire Jared Isaacman from SpaceX. A senior analytics engineer at DB Engineering was Sembroski's last position, which he held from April to July, according to his LinkedIn profile. Regarding the specifics of the new position at Blue Origin, Sembroski withheld all information. When contacted him about the employment update, he didn't react right away. Given that the two billionaires have been at odds for more than 15 years, Bezos and Elon Musk's SpaceX are recognized for their antagonism. Taking images of the crew within the capsule and of the planet below was one of Sembroski's responsibilities throughout the 3-day free-flying mission. In a viral video clip, Sembroski was seen watching Spaceballs on his tablet during the crew's return to Earth. Sembroski provided some musical moments on the ukulele while in orbit. "One of my favorite movies," Musk tweeted in response. Sembroski promised to keep pursuing his interest in space at the time. "When you step back from everything, you can see that every business is a space business," he said, according to a GeekWire interview from the time. Down in order to narrow in on his ideal location, he's now altered the trajectory of his career once more. Let's take a look at the second and last update for today. Over the weekend, two Falcon 9 rockets were covertly launched by SpaceX. Two new spacesuits for NASA were among the roughly 3 tons of supplies that the first rocket carried to the International Space Station on Friday night. There are now more than 2,500 operational internet spacecraft in orbit, a record for the launch company at the moment, thanks to the launch of 53 additional Starlink satellites on Sunday's second flight. The Falcon 9 launches attracted relatively little notice from the general public and the space community because they've become so routine. SpaceX has successfully launched 31 rockets so far this year. The number of Falcon 9 boosters orbited in 2021 is represented by this figure. SpaceX has upped its cadence this year, though, with a range of payloads, including its Starlink satellites, crew and cargo flights for NASA, Department of Defense missions, and commercial satellites. By Monday, the Falcon 9 rocket had put about 300,000 pounds in low Earth orbit, launching one every 6.4 days for the whole year. This is a considerable amount more when compared to the countries and enterprises of the rest of the globe combined. There will likely be two more Starlink releases this week. SpaceX has pushed reusability to its furthest boundaries. The company made its 13th journey in the preceding month, flying three different initial stages. SpaceX officials claim that they have enough knowledge about reusing these first-stage cores that there don't seem to be any barriers stopping them from launching a large number of additional missions, at least for the time being. To put this cadence into perspective, think about United Launch Alliance, SpaceX's main US-based competitor. Using both its Delta and Atlas fleets, ULA launched its last 31 rockets between March 19, 2017 until the present. In other words, one launch happens every 64 days. SpaceX presently launches 10 rockets for every one that its primary American rival launches. Both companies have only enjoyed success over this time. The nature of this competition will evolve throughout the following years. ULA's next heavy-lift Vulcan rocket is most likely to make its debut in the first quarter of 2023. The company's cadence may significantly accelerate as a result of a protracted launch manifest that includes institutional clients and Amazon's Project Kuiper. This will probably occur in the middle of the 2020s as ULA develops its operations and Vulcan production capabilities. Additionally, SpaceX is developing its newest rocket, the Starship. This ultra-heavy-lift rocket will most likely begin a series of test flights from South Texas in the next 6 months. SpaceX is also expanding its Florida operations to launch Starship and its Super Heavy rocket frequently. The company has stacked a number of an orbital launch tower's components pieces at the Launch Complex 39A location at the Kennedy Space Center in order to accomplish this. Prior to Friday's cargo launch for NASA, photographer Trevor Malman was able to capture a zoomable panorama of the launch tower for ARS using a remote camera setup. The exact distribution of SpaceX's Starship launch responsibilities between South Texas and Florida is as yet unknown. However, it seems more likely that the company will start conducting Starship exploratory test flights from Texas and only go on the Florida range once it's sure of the vehicle's capabilities. This makes sense in light of the high-value assets that are controlled by NASA, the Department of Defense, the National Reconnaissance Office, and other launch companies nearby in Florida. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.